Good morning.
Good morning.
Hello.
You have audio on that?
There's some.
Hi! Alright, it's Wednesday, it's the last day out of two, and this is Julian.
Hi, Julian.
Julian, I heard you drove from Delaware.
Yes.
And you also stopped in Pottstown.
No.
Oh, alright.
No, we didn't get the thing.
Alright.
Oh.
So.
We'll make it work.
Well, it doesn't matter, we have way new things.
Yep.
To do.
We sure do.
Way new, dude.
Yeah. Morning. We worked until about midnight. My brain is getting slower than usual due to lack of sleep and because of all the things which we have now written on a big list. So engine is back out already, about to drop the subframe. Got to do the brake master cylinder, a bunch of cleaning up things in the bay. We worked out that the crank pulley on the later VR6 3.6 is a different style than the early ones and it's not interchangeable, so we're going to get that machined right now, somewhere, somehow.
We had a nice clamp, just do that and cut it right there. Cut the inner down just so it's flush. Not necessarily that line, but you know, just, and that's it. Then that gives us a clearance. We can get the engine up into position.
Otherwise, it's just keep hustling. Lots of new parts to go on still. Yeah, you also remember to like eat and drink because hydrating is good. But really, spirits are good. I'm just a little bit of a zombie, but very excited. End of today goals. Hopefully the suspension that was overnighted and arriving yesterday arrives today. It was very last minute from Germany, so that's a heck of a thing. Get the engine bolted in, axles in, all those new beautiful bolts, parts, everything in. That would be a great end at 5 p.m., which is 8 hours from now. Yay, go team. The whole outer ring's now completely cut, but these four inner stanchions are still connected, and cutting it with the cutoff wheel is particularly hard, so we're gonna try this instead. Now we put it on a micrometer and check the runoff to factory specifications. We're trying to remove a damper from the outside of a crank pulley and it looks like it's bonded by a material that has a operating temperature of like 400 degrees, which is not that high. So we're hoping that it's just gonna kind of go away. Yeah, that's the trick. Go around the outside.
Go around the outside, round the outside, round the outside.
And I think we're just hitting the temperature it's failing at.
Look at that.
Look at that.
Wow.
Oh, beautiful.
Hell yeah, boys.
Oh, we have discovered a new way.
That was cool as shit, dude.
Yeah, somewhere some Volkswagen engineer in Germany's like, oh, yeah. What just happened? Oh, this is a disturbance. Okay, a lot of progress in the last 2 hours. I always look at my watch like it's there now, looking at my tattoo. So, on the big list, brake master cylinder change. Yes, Julian drove up from Delaware this morning, like 5 hours. He did that already. Clean booster reservoir done. Heater core hoses, no. That's until the engine goes back in. Engine, machine crank, oh my gosh, yes. It is done, it is spectacular. So we ran over right around the corner, Innovative Motorsport, with this used to be one piece crank pulley. And it's a damper setup. We tried a variety of ways to try and take it apart. It turned out heating the outer ring, which we're throwing away, caused it to expand and it literally just raised up off of it. It's spectacular. Then we could harvest the damper material out of there and that left a pulley. The whole reason it had a harmonic damper was to reduce vibration in the drivetrain. But if it's not balanced, it'll put extra vibrations into the drivetrain, and that could potentially lead to increased bearing wear on the crank, or a complete meltdown. If you're at 6,000 some RPM on the Nürburgring and your rod decides to no longer hold in place, it will come through the side of the block and go flying. So this is now being clamped down, milled flat. Is this a OEM or an OEM plus solution? Well, it's a solution. Will it work? I'm sure it will. What's the longevity? Well, this car is probably never going to drive long enough to find out. But we are back in business. So we can now clear the frame rail. I can work on that front mount, put the engine back in for a second time now, test fit it. It's all hands on deck, game on. I'm going to stop talking because my brain is getting slower and just super focused on cars.
I got our starter here.
Go for it.
You want me to do that? All right. I'll leave that with you for now.
So, please call a certified technician.
All right.
Oh, there it is. Look at that. It's in. Oh my God. 20 starters later.
Hell yeah.
Well done. Thank you for driving to Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Dude, Bridgeport for the win.
Next up on the list, suspension. This was literally made in Germany, custom ordered through Suspension Make It Yours program, which gives you an option of about 20 different spring colors, and you can also go further than that with customization. So this literally got overnighted. Supposed to arrive yesterday, but hey, came from Germany and arrived the following morning. So drum roll, please. I'm excited for this. Dear Jamie Orr, on behalf of the entire ST Suspension Team worldwide, we're pleased to present you with your ST Make It Yours Harlequin kit number 2 of 2 for the Junkyard Harlequin project. Kit number 1, because this has been done once before, was used on your Polo Harlequin at SEMA 2019. This is so nice. And we are thrilled to have you back with another amazing project for SEMA 2021. So they do offer this as an off-the-shelf customizationable program. So if you want to order it with all green, you can do that. They offer all blue or all red. What they don't offer is 4 individual colors. So thank you very much for allowing me to go slightly off script or off of the website, but this is literally available for an extra like 100 euros or something. Basically all KW and ST is made to order now, but because of that, when they're in Germany, they can make them any color you want, and it only adds an extra day or so to your order time. So they have the full strut mounts with the spherical bearings and everything, so we're properly going on some motorsport action here. 2 fronts, 2 rears, gonna get these mounted up literally right now. Big thank you to the entire team from ST. All right, brakes. And true SEMA fashion, overnighting parts all around the world. This is from Black Forest Industries in Cary, North Carolina, who have been part of my Harlequin build since day number 1. Got some Wilwoods, made in USA, I believe. Yeah, even the Wilwoods are Harlequinized. Yes, you could have done a solid red and blue. That would have been too obvious. So Black Forest went above and beyond. They do have an in-house, oh, there it is. Look, little Black Forest Industries logo CNC'd on the adapters. Joe, one of their founders, has a Mark III Golf, and this is what he runs in his own. So they are literally living this. Wow.
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 Wow. This is amazingly light. This is super cool. So, two-piece rotors, six piston. Literally says on the front of it, six piston. So I thought we were doing four. Nope, we're doing two more because even more race car. Color matched Wilwood six pistons with in-house designed and built Black Forest Industries. Adapters to the original hubs, which we've already put the new wheel bearings on. We put new hubs on the spindles. All of that's already been done. We just got the ST suspension. We've got the crank machine down. It is lunchtime, but apart from that, let's just bolt a lot of stuff on this car in the next 5 hours as quickly as possible. Let's do it. It is 4 p.m. on day two, which means we have now been working for about 32 hours in our 36-hour target. So, a lot of solutions found. Got a new starter, worked out the spacers for the starter. The front motor mount bracket is still not, doesn't have a solution, but we now have everything in place to develop that solution. Right now, the engine's going back in for the second time. It won't be able to come off the hoist. So we're just gonna put it in, leave it on the hoist, bolt in the two in the back, then I can work on modifying that front bracket. The target, the angle, once the motor's in, bolted in, suspension's in, brakes are bolted up, steering's bolted up, that's always been our target. I was hoping to get some of the wiring done, but there's always tomorrow at my own shop for that. But everything that's sitting on the shelves at FCP Euro, we now have sitting here. We just gotta finish bolting it on the darn car. So, back to work. The engine mounts are finally attached. The front engine mount gave me a little bit of an issue because, well, it looks like Volkswagen changed the engine block and didn't notify the internet or the world. But all three Black Forest Industries motor mounts are all bolted up with the factory engine brackets. So let's give it a go and see if the engine is indeed mounted up properly with the axles attached and everything. Lowering. Wait, hang on. We didn't tighten the front.
Front what?
We didn't tighten the front cross member.
I was thinking about that.
Where are you? You were thinking about it, not seeing it?
I didn't say nothing, because I didn't see
it. You see something, say something, kids. If you see something, say something.
I didn't see nothing.
Well, you thought it. So that is why I walk around with an ink pen, and whenever something's properly torqued when we're doing one of these kind of group projects, whoever actually checks the torque on every belt puts an ink mark on it. And that means later, if I'm working alone and I see something that doesn't have an ink mark on it, I know, double check it. It's either good news, someone did tighten it, put the mark, or it's bad news, it's fine news, tighten it, whatever. So, with an audience behind the camera, we'll use the universal tool and hopefully this will not fall out. That's it. It didn't move. That's what we wanted. What do you want? You think it's gonna like fall into place? It's already bolted up. That's exactly what we wanted. Nothing. No drama. No muss, no fuss. Just yay. Hooray! Wait, we're not clapping, it's not done yet. Like, you know, all right. They're like, yay, it's leaving. It is coming up to 11 p.m. on day two here at the beautiful FCP warehouse. And well, we went over the 36 hours. We're pushing 38 hours, but we've managed to get so much done. The engine is now fully bolted in. Axles are all tightened up. Beautiful suspension. We test fitted the amazing Wilwood brakes from Black Forest Industries. Tectonics exhaust is bolting on. The list goes on, and so do I, apparently. So now it's gonna go on the trailer with me back to my windowless warehouse. I've got approximately 9-10 days left to get it fully wrapped up, plus two other projects in time to go on the trailer to the SEMA show 2,500 miles away in Las Vegas. So if you've been following along with FCP Euro, thank you so much. This is not the end of the project, but this is going to be the end of us sharing a lot of it, because we have lots more secrets to come. So stay tuned. We will have more to share, but not right now. Hey, thank you so, so much for following along. Thank you to everyone that has any interest in what I'm doing, SEP Euro is doing, absolutely everything. Please have fun with your cars and have fun following us along. Please consider subscribing. You gotta be shopping on SCPEuro.com already, right? Take care, see you soon.
Hello?
Oh shit.
So Mr. President?
Can I pull this through?
Hang on, JR, I'm on the phone. Yeah, yeah, he said pull it. Pull it.
Is it like diesel it?
Pull it gently.
I'm pulling it.
I'm trying to tell him, dude, but you know, this guy just gorillas it or he doesn't do it at all. Vacuum? I know, I told him to vacuum the glass out like half an hour ago. He said, nah, we shouldn't do that yet. I was gonna be crawling around it all night.
Bro.
All right, yeah, I'll let him know.
Yeah.
6:30.
What?
Dinner's fine, yeah, okay.
No, I want dinner.
No, you're not.
What kind of foolishness is this?
All right. Did you pull it out?
I'm pulling.
Hang on, hang on.